Hey, what's up everyone? In this video, we are going to be covering a ton. First, we are going to show you the new AMVR facial interface and foam replacement set for the Quest 2, what purpose it serves, and how to install it. After that, but before I give my opinion on if you should buy it, I also wanted to compare it to every other option out there for you. This would be a complete comparison versus VR Cover's facial interface set, a silicone cover, and a cloth cover. I want you to feel confident before you make your decision on which face cover suits you best. So let's get started. Before I get started on this section, I want everyone to understand that AMVR approached me to review their new facial interface set and did provide it to me at no cost. Having said that, I am still here to provide you all with my unbiased opinion, and as it stands, I love everything that I bought from AMVR so far. That would be the battery power bank, their grips, and their facial interface set for the Valve Index. All of these products are amazing. The AMVR facial interface and foam replacement set contains several things: a bracket with a Velcro pad on it, two foam pads, one 8mm and one 12mm, side wedges for the facial interface for small faces, a VR lens cover, and an anti-leakage nose pad. All of this for $27 is an incredible value, and I want everyone to know right off the bat that all of the included pieces perform their functions without any issues. The purpose of the facial interface set is to increase your field of view, provide an easy to clean face pad, stop light from leaking around your nose, vent hot air around your face so there's less fog, and to protect your lenses from scratches. Next, I will explain how to install it all. Installation is pretty simple. First, you want to remove your previous facial interface bracket. Be careful not to scratch your Quest lenses. Next, you want to take AMVR facial interface bracket, and if you have a smaller face and want less light leakage on the sides and more padding, attach the wedges to the sides of the bracket. Next, you want to fold the 8 or 12 millimeter pads in half like shown and apply it to the top middle of the bracket and fold it out, making sure that it is secured to the Velcro and doesn't move. After that, you want to apply the nose pad on the inside of the bracket. To do that, you line up the two holes on the pad to the two pins on the bracket and slide it in, making sure that it is secured. Last, you want to apply the bracket back onto the Quest 2. I find that lining up the bottom part first with the two pins and holding that in place while you adjust the top to be the best way to do it, making sure it snaps in all four positions, two on the bottom and two on the top. That's it, you're all finished. I am told that it is compatible with the original glasses spacer that Oculus provided. You simply attach the spacer to the bracket with the four spots that lock in, two on the top and two on the bottom. Then, with that combined, you attach the entire interface to the Quest 2. I found the lens protector to be basic but adequate. I find the best way to use it is to keep the bracket on and snugly wedge the protector up against the lenses and making sure it doesn't fall out or wobble. That about covers the installation guide. Next, we will talk about if it's worth it and which face cover is best for you. It's time for a showdown. Yes, that's right. Which face cover is best and which one is best for you? Well, I have four to compare here today, and let me tell you, there's a lot to discuss. The four we are looking at are the AMVR facial interface set, the VR cover facial interface set, which both of these are leather-like foam pads, a silicone cover, which goes right over the original bracket on the Quest, and last of all, a cloth cover that also fits on the original bracket. First, we're going to discuss costs. Starting at the most inexpensive, we have the silicone covers. Depending on where you buy it from, these are super cheap and come in around $10 to $20. They work by fitting directly over the original bracket. They are simple to put on and easy to keep clean. If you don't mind the feeling of silicone, this is probably your best bet. Next up, we have the cloth covers. I don't particularly like cloth covers. There are also no light blockers for them. If you really don't care for leather, silicone, or the feel of the original foam but still want your Quest clean, these are for you. You're also able to take them off and wash them if you want. They do work well, and I keep cloth covers on my index head strap since I sweat a ton. They are comfy, they do the job, but they come in closer to $20. It's also important to note that neither of these two options allow you to vent hot air from the inside of your Quest 2, so fog may build up if you work out. Last on our list is comparing the VR Cover Facial Interface Set and the AMVR Facial Interface Set. I could talk about these two and their differences for quite a while, so what I just wanted to do is list them quickly so that you can make your own informed decision. Let's start out by talking about the strengths of AMVR. First, they do increase your field of view, more than the VR cover. This is because the inserts are 8mm and 12mm thick, which is quite thin. Next up, AMVR is a fantastic brand name and is carried all across Amazon, which allows for easy purchasing and returns should you change your mind. VR cover, you pay shipping yourself, which is $7, and return shipping should you change your mind. Next, AMVR's vents for venting fog and heat work moderately well. If you are not a massive sweater and are going to do mild to moderate workouts, the vents will perform exactly as you would expect. Any intense workouts and significant sweating, the vents may start to fall behind and fog could build up. Still, this is pretty good, considering that the trade-off of increased field of view is being closer to the lenses, which means that fog buildup is going to happen sooner. Next is the interface bracket is half silicone and half plastic. Why does this matter? In the event the bracket is pressing on your face, VR cover's bracket is solid, thick plastic, which you don't feel because of the thick foam. But AMVR went with half plastic, half silicone, so it has some give to it, which does improve comfort. Last is the value. Overall, the AMVR set provides a significantly better value over the VR cover set. Yes, they are not as thick, but you don't have to pay the $7 shipping. You do get a working lens cover, and it provides everything VR cover set does. It just costs less. It's time to take the flip side, however. In which ways does VR cover shine? Well, VR cover comes with two very, very thick pads. I'm talking super thick. These are like 20mm, and they don't lose any field of view over the original base bracket and foam, but you don't gain anything either. Being as you have more foam, your face is further from the lenses, which means the fog buildup will be less. If you work out very hard in VR and you sweat a ton, you may want to consider this set over AMVR. Both facial interface brackets function almost the same, and I really can't see too much difference on them, but they do look a bit different. I think it's important to note that AMVR's brackets leak light on its sides, not the bottom. In very bright rooms, the inside of the bracket will be a bright red, which could be distracting. VR cover's bracket is very thick and no light leaks anywhere. The last thing I want to mention is the simple fact that with VR cover, most of the time you have to deal with their own customer service and their own website. If something goes wrong or you don't like the product, you have to pay for your own return shipping. All of AMVR's products are on Amazon, and for the most part, I can vouch for the simplicity of Amazon's ordering and return policy. A few VR customers have reached out to me with complaints about VR cover's lacking service. In the end, the choice is yours. I very much love my AMVR facial replacement set and all of the other accessories that I have bought from AMVR as well. If you find yourself not working out too hard in VR on the Quest 2, this is a solid buy for you. That's all for this video, everyone. Please consider dropping a like, a comment, or subscribing and hitting the bell. I'm going to continue to review products and bring you my unbiased opinions and hope you find them all useful. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!